Let me tell you one beautiful story here so that you catch the point firmly. This story also occurs in the Keno Upanishad. It's a very profound Upanishad. This story goes like this. It seems once there was a quarrel between the Devas and Asuras in heaven. This is a story just to illustrate, tell you about something very profound about yourselves. So observe the story. There was a quarrel between, there are periodic quarrels between Devas and Asuras. So during one such war, the Devas managed to drive the Asuras out of heaven. And once the Asuras left and they were killed and hammered and thrown out, the Devas became very happy and jubilant because they had won the war and they started celebrating. And the celebrations went on for a long time. So you know who these Devas are? The gods with the small g. They are like divine offices in heaven. This is how it is conceived. It is like Indra, who is the god of the heaven, Varuna, who is the god of the waters. They are all offices, divine offices in control of each element. Ek ek panchabhut ke devata hai ye. Agni is in charge of fire, Vayu is in charge of wind. So these gods, they are called lesser gods in Hinduism. So these gods started feeling very arrogant about their victory and they went on celebrating. They were over enthusiastic, over jubilant. So then God, which Brahman, the supreme consciousness, he thought that they must be taught a lesson. They must be made to think, who is it who is responsible for their victory? What is the source of their victory? So he appeared before them in the form of a yaksha. Yaksha means a celestial being. A very bright, luminous being appeared there. And Indra looked at that being and said, who is this? Who has come into the heavens again? And then he sent Agni first to find out who this yaksha was. Agni went to the yaksha and then the yaksha placed a bit of straw in front of him and said, oh, I didn't know who you are. Agni said, you don't know me. I can burn down the whole world. I am the greatest Agni. And the yaksha said, oh, can you please burn this bit of straw for me? And then it seems Agni tried his best, huffed and puffed and tried to burn down that straw, but that straw would not burn. And then Agni was felt very strange. What is this? Something very strange is going on here. And he went back to Indra and said, you see, this is no ordinary being. Something very mysterious going on. So you send somebody else and we'll try to find out what is this. So he sent Vayu. Again, the bit of straw was placed in front of Vayu. And Vayu said, you want me to blow out this bit of straw? I can do such great things. You don't know who I am. I am the mightiest god. And the yaksha said, yes, please blow out this bit of straw now. But he couldn't do it. He also huffed and puffed and tried to blow out. He who creates storms and thunderstorms and hurricanes on earth, he could not blow out that bit of straw. So he also came back to Indra and said, this is a very mysterious being. He is not of the ordinary group. So try to find out who he is. Then Indra came there. As soon as Indra came, that celestial being vanished. And then Brahma Vidya, the knowledge of Brahman, came in an embodied form, in the form of a Devi there, Uma Haimavati. And she tells Indra that, don't you know who was this celestial being? He was none other than Brahman, the supreme consciousness who came to show you that without his being there, without his permission, nothing can move. Agni cannot do anything, Vayu cannot do anything, none of you can do anything. So please acknowledge this. And she gave him this Vidya, that is why they say Indra became the greatest of the gods. What is this story trying to tell us? Basically, the Upanishad is trying to tell you, without the presence of consciousness, even mind does not function. Not to speak of your sense organs. Nothing will function. The mind itself, last time I showed you a slide with this figure, mind is lit up by consciousness reflected into it. And that is how the body also gets enlivened. And that is how you are functioning in this world. So the source factor for all of this is consciousness. The self, the Atman, standing behind everything due to which you are being able to function in this world. This is what they are trying to tell you.